Welcome to another update on COVID. I'm Professor Bob Graham at the Victor Chang Cardiac Research Institute. So we've come a long way in the pandemic, and fortunately Australia has done very well. But I'm sure those of you with heart disease are worried now because we're coming into the time when we're starting to get the vaccine. And I guess the first question a lot of you might have is the vaccine safe in people who've got heart disease? The answer is that both the Pfizer vaccine that's going to be available for some of us in Australia and the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine have been shown to be safe in people with heart disease. So I would urge you to take it, because if you don't, the chances of getting serious illness with COVID are very high in people with cardiovascular disease. There's no indication that the vaccine will interfere with their medications. A lot of the people in the trials that had heart disease were on medications, and there were no problems because of that. The only concerns that heart disease patients might have is if they have a known allergy to any of the ingredients in the vaccines or to previous vaccinations, and also if they're on blood thinners. And a lot of heart patients are on blood thinners. That's not doesn't preclude you from getting the vaccine. In fact, you should still get it. It may mean that you'll get a bit more bruising or you get a bit of bleeding at the site where you have the injection, and that can easily be stopped by putting pressure on for a reasonable period of time to stop the bleeding. So there's no contraindication to heart disease patients getting the vaccine. Look, the worst case scenario is if you don't get the vaccine and you get COVID, because you're at a much higher risk. So the risk-benefit ratio for heart disease patients is enormous. For patients who don't have heart disease, the risk-benefit ratio is anywhere between 2,200 to 1 to 220,000 to 1 that you're going to be worse off if you don't get the vaccine and you contract COVID. So the risk-benefit ratio favours people with heart disease, particularly getting the vaccine. There are no contraindications or no known side effects in people getting who have got heart disease in terms of getting the vaccine. So there's no reason not to get it. There's no evidence that they're having more than one vaccine worries people. I mean, don't forget, all of us have had things like DPT, which is diphtheria, pertussis, toxin, tetanus, which is three vaccines given all at once. And then most of us every year get a flu jab as well. Our body's very good at coping with these vaccines, and they stimulate different cells to produce different antibodies. So there's no evidence that having a heart condition will cause you problems if you have multiple vaccines. And certainly if you've got a heart condition, you should not only have the COVID vaccine, but you should also have a flu shot once a year and probably a pneumovax to prevent you from getting pneumonia once a year as well. They both protect people who have got heart disease, and they also protect people who are older, and they also protect people with different ethnic groups. So they both seem to be very protective. The Pfizer vaccine seems to protect people after you've had two doses. Both of them require two doses, to the extent of about 94%, reducing serious illnesses. And the AstraZeneca about 70%. But even those who got COVID, none of them required hospitalization if they've had the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. So both of them seem to provide very good protection from serious disease. We don't know the answer for how long. The COVID virus is mutating. It mutates more slowly than the flu virus. So the flu virus has to be given every year. We hope that the COVID vaccine will last a lot longer than that, so that hopefully you don't have to get a jab every year. But if you do, it's not the end of the world, because it is providing enormous protection. The only grounds for not having a vaccine is if you've got a known allergy to any of the constituents of the vaccine, which is very, very rare, or if you've got an immune problem where you can't mount an immune response. And there was a very interesting case recently at Harvard where somebody had a very serious immune response. And what was interesting about that case was that that patient, his virus seemed to change very quickly, and it seemed to evolve much more quickly than normal people. And we think that's where these new strains are coming from. In fact, people who've got immune problems are producing different strains of virus very quickly, and they're exactly the sort of people we need to protect, because they're the ones who then shed the virus and give it out to the community, and then it starts to spread. Well, look, every year we have to produce a new vaccine for the flu. As I mentioned before, the SARS-CoV-2 virus that causes COVID-19 doesn't seem to be mutating as quickly. So hopefully the vaccine will be good, but it wouldn't surprise me that in a few years' time we may need to modify the vaccine so that it is effective against new strains. Look, I would urge you strongly to consider having the vaccine because, as I mentioned, the risk-benefit ratio is so much in favour of having the vaccine against not having it. If you don't have the vaccine and you've got a heart problem and you get COVID, your chances of getting serious illness are very much higher than somebody who doesn't have heart disease, particularly if you've got heart function that's not as good as normal. And they're the sort of people who've got atrial fibrillation, who have had coronary artery disease, who've got congenital heart disease, etc. So they're the sort of people who should be very much pushing themselves to the front of the queue and getting the vaccine. Thank you again for joining us at the Victor Chang Cardiac Research Institute for another update on COVID, and particularly for those people who've got cardiovascular heart problems, because they're the group that we're most interested in. And I'm sure if you have heart problems, you're interested in whether or not you should take the vaccine. And as I mentioned, I'd encourage you to seriously think about having it because the risk-benefit ratio is so much in favor of the vaccine.